So the magnetic quantum number is the third quantum number. And the work of the magnetic quantum number is that it describes the possible orientations of the orbitals in space. You know, orbitals, the orientation differs. Some of the orbitals may be moving in the x-axis, some may be moving in the y-axis, while some may be moving in the z-axis. So the work of the magnetic quantum number is to describe the possible orientation of the orbitals in space. For instance, if we draw something like this, this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, and this is S orbital. It could, the orientation could be towards this direction or towards this direction, but what will help us to know the particular orientation of the orbitals in a space is the magnetic quantum number. So when we talk about the P orbitals, the P orbital can assume three different orientation. They can be moving towards the y-axis, in the direction of the y-axis. This is y-axis, this is x-axis. So in this case, we call this PY orbital. The orientation is towards the y-axis. So we can also have when the orientation is towards the x-axis. This is the y-axis, this is the x-axis. The orientation is towards the x-axis. We can call this the PX orbital. Then the orientation can also be towards the z-axis. If the orientation is in this direction, the z-axis, we call this the PZ orbital. This is our y, this is our x. So this is PZ orbital. Now, the work of this magnetic quantum number is to tell us the possible orientation of these orbitals in space. And with the magnetic quantum number, you can be able to know the maximum number of electrons a particular subshell we have. Let's take for instance, if N is equal to 3, then my L will be equal to 0, 1, and 2. Remember that L is 0 to N minus 1. That means you start a number from 0, you now go to N minus 1. 3 is here, and 3 minus 1 is 2, which means the number will stop at 2. Then the ML, which is the magnetic quantum number, will now become minus 2. You start from the minus of this to the positive of it. Minus 2, the minus 1, 0, 1, and 2. Because the integer ranges from ML, the integer is minus L to plus L. That means it will start from the negative of the value of L to the positive of it. I have 2 as the maximum number here. So it will be minus 2, minus 1, 0. It will now change to the positive of the number. Just like if I have L as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I want to find ML. It's simple. Just be putting minus, 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 minus until you reach 0. Then you turn it to plus. That is the magnetic quantum number. This will become minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that is the way to get the magnetic quantum number. It's from the value of the azimuthal quantum number, the negative of it, then you go to the positive. Whatever value you have there is the value for the magnetic quantum number. Now, this magnetic quantum number can help us to know the maximum number of electrons in a subshell. Like this is the subshell here is S, P, and D. We are describing the D subshell. The maximum number of electrons it can carry is this, 2, 2, 2, 2, and 2, which is 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6, 8, 10. The maximum number of electrons D can carry. Maximum number of electrons, maximum number of electron for D is equal to 10 electrons. So the D subshell will carry maximum of 10 electrons. Remember that the azimuthal quantum number is given in this way, S, P, D, and F. The azimuthal quantum number for this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. So we are dealing with the D orbital, that is why we use the one of 2. And the maximum number of electrons there is 10. That is 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. That is 10 electrons. And the number of orbitals here is going to be 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these have given me the number of orbitals there. So the magnetic quantum number, we can use it to know the possible orientation of the orbitals in space. We can use it to know the number of the electrons, the maximum number of electrons that each subshell can be able to carry. From there, we can also be able to know the number of orbitals present. So let's take, for instance, we are asked to find the number of orbitals present in the P, as well as the one present in the F. For P now, the L for P, L for it is 1. So the ML will become minus 1, 0 to plus 1. Now, the maximum number of electrons that P can carry is 2, 4, 6. So the maximum number of electrons it can carry is 6 electrons, which is 2, 4, 6. Maximum number of electrons, for P is equal to 6 electrons. And the number of orbitals in P are 3. 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 orbitals in P. If we are talking about the F subshell, and I want to know the maximum number of electrons it can carry, I can as well do it using the magnetic quantum number. The L for F is 3, so my ML, the magnetic quantum number, will be minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Just the number, you'll be putting the minus sign on the number, like minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. Then once you reach 0, you now count the positive. The 0 is the transition between the negative and the positive number there. Now, if I want to know the maximum number of electrons that this F can carry, each of these will be 2 electrons, because each orbital carries 2 electrons. 2, 2, and 2. This is 2 plus 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. So maximum number of electrons, for F is equal to 14 electrons. So that is the way you can know the maximum number of electrons and the number of orbitals. The number of orbitals here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 orbitals. That is method 1. Another method you can also use to get the same thing is what I'm going to give you now. All right, so the formula for finding number of orbitals, in case if you don't want to use the other method we use, there is another method. I think this one is shorter. The formula is 2L plus 1. And this L stands for the azimuthal quantum number. So this formula will help you to know the number of orbitals. Maybe you are asked to determine the number of orbitals in S subshell, the number of orbitals in P subshell, the number of orbitals in D subshell. So you just use this formula, 2L plus 1. Now, to know the maximum number of electrons in a particular subshell, it is 2 times number of orbitals. You now know the maximum number of electrons in a subshell. Example, S subshell. The number of orbitals is 2L plus 1. And the L for the S subshell is 0. So the number of orbital will be 2 into bracket 0 plus 1. 2 times 0 is 0, which is going to be 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. So the number of subshell that S has is 1 orbital. The number of orbital in S subshell is only 1 orbital. So 1 orbital is present. 1 orbital is present in S subshell. So if you come to S subshell, is only 1 orbital that you will see there. And the maximum number of electron S can carry, maximum number of electron, is equals to 2 times number of orbitals. The number of orbitals here is one orbital. So maximum number of electrons will be 2 times 1, which is 2. So anytime you have s orbital, the maximum number of electron s can carry is 2 electrons. You can't give s anything greater than 2. S can have less than 2, which is 1, but it can never have 3. You can never give 3 electrons to s. The maximum it can have is 2 electrons. Then the next is maybe P orbital or D orbital, anyone you want to get, it is possible. For the P number of orbital is equals to 2L plus 1. The number of orbital for the P subshell is 2L plus 1. And the L for the P is 1. This is 0, 1. P is 1. So when you substitute 1 to this equation, it becomes 2 into bracket 1 plus 1. 2 times 1 is 2. Plus 1, which will give us 3. And this 3 now tells us that the number of orbitals in P subshell is 3. So the number of orbitals here is 3. 3 orbitals are present. 3 orbitals are present in P subshell. So if you have P subshell, you have 3 orbitals. And what are those orbitals? The orbitals are the PX, the PY, and the PZ. These are those 3 orbitals that are present in the P subshell. Then the maximum number of electron, that P can carry is 2 multiplied by number of orbital. The number of orbital in P is 3. So 2 times 3 is equal to 6 electrons. So the maximum number of electron P subshell can carry is 6 electron. Then when you talk about the D subshell. Okay, so for D subshell, we want to know the number of orbitals that can be present in the D subshell. The L, the azimuthal quantum number for D is 2. And the formula is 2L plus 1. The formula you can use to know the number of orbitals is 2L plus 1. So 2 times 2 plus 1. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1. That will give 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. So the number of orbitals that are present in D is 5 orbitals. The orbitals include the D, X, Y, the D, X, Z, the D, Y, Z, the D, X square minus Y square, and the D, Z square. These are the 5 orbitals that are present in the D subshell. And the maximum number of electrons that D can carry is 2 times 5, because we have 5 orbitals there in the subshell. So 2 multiplied by 5 will give you 10 electrons. So the maximum number of electrons that D can carry is equal to 10 electrons. So with this, you can be able to know the number of orbitals using this formula. You can determine the number of orbitals, 2L plus 1, and each of these subshell has their L value. The L value for the S is 0, for P is 1, for D is 2, then for F is 3. You just substitute the 0, the number here. If it is 0, you substitute it here plus 1. If it is 1, you substitute whatever value you substitute to this equation, and you get the number of orbitals. Now, for you to know the number, maximum number of electron you can get, the maximum number of electron is 2 times the number of orbital. It is twice the number of orbitals. Take, for instance, the number of orbital here is 5. Then maximum number of electron will be 2 times 5, which will give us 10 electrons. So in this case now, the number of orbital is 3. Then the maximum number of electron you can carry is twice 3. That is 2 times 3, which will be 6. And the reason why we are multiplying by 2 is that each orbital can house 2 electrons. Can house 2 electrons means it can carry 2 electrons. You cannot give more than 2 electrons to a particular orbital. It's either the electron is going up or it is coming down. You can't give more than 2 like this to any orbital. If it is PX, PY, and PZ, you give this one 2, this one 2, this one 2. So all of them summed together will give what? 6 electrons that can be present in anything P, which is this 6 electron here that can be present in P. So with You can be able to know the maximum number of electrons and the subshells in each of the subshells and the possible orbitals that are present.
All right, so from there, we can be able to give the number of orbitals, the shell, the maximum number of electrons, like we have the subshell. When the subshell is a S subshell, the number of orbitals is 1. Maximum number of electron is 2. We said that the maximum number of electron is just 2 times the number of orbitals. And the formula for finding the number of orbitals is 2L plus 1. So when the subshell is P, number of orbital is 3. Maximum number of electron is 6. The same thing is applicable to other ones there.